A while ago, I only played Jett during my Road to Diamond series with Jett only. During this series, I always gave a lot of tips and tricks, and every game I learned something new. But I never made a summary of all the things that I've learned. And that's why I'm making this video. In this video, I'm gonna tell you everything that I've learned when playing Jett. Let's first talk about her passive ability. When Jett is in the sky, you can fly if you are holding your spacebar. If you are also holding your crouch button, your feet will go up and you can jump to higher places, like the truck combined or these boxes on Haven. Use this trick so you don't have to use your updraft ability. Now, let's talk about her updraft ability. One thing you have to know is that you jump the highest if you use your updraft and you jump at the same time. Don't jump first and then use your updraft, because then you will go less high. An example where this is very important is over here on Ascent. You can only jump on top of this wall if you use both your updraft and your jump at the same time. And believe me when I say, this spot can give you a lot of free kills.
Waarschijnlijk op B en camp.
Kijk eens aan.
Kijk, dat is een clippy hoor, dat is een clippy. Another very good way you can use your updraft is in combination with your ult. With this combo, you can get to sneaky spots where the enemies don't expect you. And believe me, even in diamond, these spots still work. However, a tip I can give you is to don't use your updraft immediately after you use your ult. Wait a little bit so the enemies maybe forget about your ult and then do your updraft. In the background you saw a few of these spots. Now let's talk about the smokes. If you hold your C button, you can curve the smoke to wherever you want. Use this if you want to smoke things without fully peeking an angle. An example is this beautiful curve to Heaven. You can also use your smoke to ninja defuse. Just smoke the bomb once, then defuse to half, smoke again, and finish the defuse. Easy peasy.
Garage.
Last player standing.
Easy.
Easy.
Two other ways you can use a smoke is for one ways or block a side while you are pushing something, like you see in the clip in the background. I know that this was the old split map, but you can still use it in the new one. Now, let's talk about her dash ability. The two main ways you can use your dash ability is to get out of sticky situations or to rush something. Let's first talk about the sticky situation part. During my Road to Diamond series, I always said, if you mess up your spray, just dash away. With that I mean, if you miss like your first 5 bullets, don't try to fix your spray, just dash away, reset, and get in from a different angle. In the clip in the background, you see an example of this.
Stay down. One enemy remaining.
So it's important to always keep a finger on the button where you dash with. For me, the E button. You can also use a dash for rushing. What I would recommend is to use your smoke first and then dash in your smoke. This way you can get fast to side, like you saw in the clip in the background. Also, it is possible to go through the cipher traps, so I would recommend to always go first if you are pushing something with the team and the enemy's got a cipher. But my favorite combo and thing to do in the game is the updraft dash combo. There are a lot of spots where you can use both your abilities to get to sneaky places. I already made a video about this though, so I won't go over every spot, but I recommend to learn some of these spots. In the background you see a few of these clips, so learn this by head. And also, this one is my favorite. Another tip for Jett, if you're gonna use your ult, always jump once before you shoot. This way you get a little bit more advantage, like you see in the clips in the background. You can also just normally peek, but it's way better to just get on higher ground and from then kill the enemy. The main reason for this is that if you got the higher grounds, the enemies will have to flick all the way above. And also, I think it's easier to shoot on the head from the higher ground. Now the last tip for Jett her ultimate. If you are using her ult, never stand still while shooting. When you are seeing someone, just keep moving. You will keep your accuracy even while you move. This way you are a harder target to hit and you can kill the enemies easy peasy. Oh yeah, and one more thing, use your right click option only in close range. Especially dashing before you use your ult works really fine, like you see in the clips in the background. But if there are 5 people close range, it's maybe even better to use your left click option. Because if you kill someone with your right click, you have a little bit of delay before you can shoot again. And your left click, you can just woonk 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 5 people easy peasy. Now, let's talk about the playstyle. Let's first talk about their attacking side. On the attacking side, you should always be the first one to enter. Especially to clear that cipher traps and just make yourself a hard target for the enemy because of your mobility. If you are pushing with Jett, it's sometimes better for you to just trade yourself one for one, So your teammates could push the site behind you, kill the last one on the site, and you get the site with your team. On the defending side, it's sometimes better to just play a little bit aggressive. And with that I mean don't play as aggressive as me, because I like to push a lot, but I mean it works with Jett sometimes. The main reason why pushing with Jett on defending side works is that if you see someone, you can dash back instantly, like nothing ever happened. So if you push, you see someone, just dash back, no problem. But don't turn the words against me. I mean, if you are pushing every round and you're dying, your teammates are raging on you, don't say, "Mr. Lowlander told me." I mean, pushing every round is not the right play. But if you like to push, sometimes, as the defender side, Jett is the agent for you. Now let's talk about a few tips for Jett. The first tip, everyone who knows me a little bit better saw this probably coming, but Jett can do the teleporter trick. Throw your smoke through the teleporter, the door will open, then push behind your smoke, and you can get easy kills. Easy peasy. Another thing you can try to do with Jett is pick up the operator. In my opinion, Jett is the best agent to use the operator with. This is because you can dash away after you make a kill. So when you play with an operator with Jett, you can also go for aggressive peeks, and if it goes wrong, just dash away instantly, easy peasy. And another tip with Jett, always go for the higher ground. You can do this with your updraft or just with your passive ability. Higher ground is key when playing Jett. And the last tip for Jett is always keep a finger on your dash ability. It is your escape if you get into nasty situations, so always keep a finger on that button. Now the real question, should you play Jett, and is Jett easy to climb ranks with? In my opinion, yes, Jett is very easy to climb ranks with. The main reason is because she is very mobile. Because she is mobile, you can stay alive for a very long time. And staying alive, making kills, is the way to rank up. Also, I think Jett is the definition for easy to learn, hard to master. Jett is very easy to learn, to know the basics, but if you want to make awesome plays with her ult, it's very hard to do. But you, my viewer, I believe in you, my friend. You are a pro player and you're gonna own with this agent. If you looked at the background, you saw a beautiful ace. And now to end this video, I'm gonna show you in 1v5.
Oh, another ult
there. Last player standing.
Oh, I'm so dead.
Headshot.
Ik kan nog steeds in.
Ik kan nog steeds. Ik heb al twee kansen.
One enemy remaining.
Ja, ja.
I got the spike.
Yes! Yes! I want to thank everyone for watching, and I can't believe the support we are getting these last few days. I mean, we grew 50k subscribers in only 2 months. Like, how? Thank you so much. It just literally changes my life. So thank you, everyone. I see you in the next one. Peace.